ऑलमोस्ट कवर कर लिया
Thank you.
Past, celebrating the golden present and envisioning the promising future is the trend which we all follow. Good evening to one and all present here. Before we start with today's program, let me pay respect and homage to our guru, guide and mentor, late lamented His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasius, the founder president of the Trust. The Trust of the Society of St. Basil was established in 1973 by the founder president, late His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasius, when he was Father K.T. Thomas, a priest of Indian Orthodox Church, to provide quality education to the children in the rural areas of Gujarat. Now the Trust has completed 50 years in the field of education. Through his vision, schools under the Trust has enlightened thousands of students to become patriotic and responsible citizens of our esteemed nation. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto thy name. To mark the commencement of the Golden Jubilee meeting of the Trust with the blessings of the Lord, the Omnipotent, we shall ask for His blessings with a Sanskrit prayer by the school choir.
Yeah.
symbol of knowledge and understanding. Without the light, it becomes impossible to acquire any knowledge and understand the world. Light illuminates our soul and gives meaning to our lives. Now I invite all the dignitaries on the dais to light the lamp.
Okay.
One hand of help, one word of sympathy, one act of humanity, one smile of charity, one message a day can change someone's life. He is a man who believes in action rather than words. I request Reverend Father Dr. M.S. John, President of the Trust of the Society of St. Basil, to deliver the welcome speech.
His Holiness Basilius Marthoma Matthews III, the Catholicos and Malangara Metropolitan, who will bless us with an online message. His Excellency Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, Governor of Goa, who will address this meeting through online and will inaugurate the Jubilee meeting of the Trust. His Grace Georgios Markourilos, Metropolitan of Mumbai Diocese of Orthodox Church of India, who will preside over the meeting. Sri Jayendra Singh Ji Parmar, MLA Halol, Sri C.K. Koshi IAS, former Additional Chief Secretary Gujarat. Both will be delivering felicitation addresses today. Mr. Varghese Thomas and Mr. Shaji Matai, Honorable Trustees, Principals, Staff, Students and Parents of the schools managed by the Trust of the Society of St. Basil, Reverend Father Isaac Thomas, Vicar and other Reverend Fathers from MGOS Church, Baroda, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to one and all present here. In 1966, a young, energetic, enthusiastic and intelligent young man got admission to Emmett Courts in the Faculty of Education and Psychology at the Maharaja Sayajirao University, Baroda, on a national scholarship. During his Emmett course, one part of his curriculum was the report on education reforms of India by a Kothari Commission. He studied it carefully, and one sentence in it struck him deeply. The future of our nation is shaped in our classrooms. He used this quotation on several occasions in the staff meeting and other educational forums. India, a newly born nation, was striving to develop in all areas. The importance of education in the nation building process was very much understood by the young Katie Thomas. His uncle, late lamented His Grace Georgios Mar Pilexinos, was a famous educationist and religious leader in Kerala. He started a number of schools and colleges in Kerala. Mr. Katie Thomas followed his uncle's path, and after Emmett studies, he got ordained and became a priest of the Malangara Orthodox Church. He organized the members of the Orthodox community in Baroda, who were very few in numbers, and started basic school in Akota, Baroda, using the fund collected for building a church for the Orthodox community. With a short span of time, this school developed as one of the best English medium schools in Baroda. In the year 1973, IOC management approached the young principal, Father Katie Thomas of Basil School, and requested him to take over the management of the English Jubilee School in the township at Devarnar, Koyali, Baroda. In the same year, he registered a public charitable trust, the Trust of the Society of St. Basil, and took over the management of the Gujarat Refinery English Jubilee School owned by Indian Oil Corporation. In 1981, he started MGM English Medium School at Halol Taluka in Panchmahal district, a backward district of Gujarat. In 1985, St. Paul's English Medium and Gujarati Medium School were started in Petrofils Township, Vadodara, for the request of Petrofils Company Management. This school was located at Petrofils Township. In the year 2016, the then Governor of Gujarat, His Excellency Mr. O.P. Kohli, inaugurated this school building, and this school was relocated here in this campus. Bishop Thomas started one CBSE school at the request of IOC management in the Refinery Township at Jawaharnagar in 2009. At present, there are five schools under this trust, started by His grace Thomas Marathanasios, our guru and guide. More than 7,000 students studies in these institutions and mold themselves to be responsible citizens of our motherland. All these schools are in rural areas of Gujarat. Bishop Thomas's mission in life was to provide quality education at reasonable cost. All these schools are acclaimed as best schools in academic and co-curricular performances. In our schools, we do not take donation for admission and appointments, and we charge only fees approved by the government. The alumni of our school are at high positions and lead a successful life in India and abroad. On this historic occasion of celebrating the 50th anniversary of the Trust, I bow my head before this great visionary and patriot, His Grace Thomas Marathanasios, the founder of the Trust. I have been given the prestigious privilege to introduce and welcome the Supreme Head of the Malangara Orthodox Church, His Holiness Basilios Marthoma Matthews III, the Catholicos and Malangara Metropolitan, who will bless us through his message, and all other dignitaries. The Indian Orthodox Church is like the Russian Orthodox Church of Russia, Coptic Church of Egypt, Armenian Orthodox Church of Armenia, Syrian Orthodox Church of Syria, etc. The Orthodox churches do not have a universal head. The head of each church in their country is supreme authority of that church. Each church is independent in administration and at the same time one in faith. His Holiness Basilios Marthoma Matthews III is the supreme head of the Orthodox Christians of Indian origin all over the world. His Holiness was ordained as a priest in the year 1978 and became a bishop of Malangara Orthodox Church in 1991. In 2021, at the age of 72, he is elevated as the Catholicos and Malangara Metropolitan, the supreme head of the church. Baba Dhirubeni happily agreed to preside over this meeting, but due to his ill health, he was admitted in hospital and he could not attend personally. But he will bless us with his message. Baba Dhirubeni, I express my heartfelt gratitude for blessing us with a message in spite of your ill health. His Excellency Sridharan Pillai, the Honorable Governor of Goa, has agreed to attend this program. When I invited him, he readily agreed and told me he and His Grace Thomas Marathanasios were good friends and they were hailing from same place. In Goa, it is Christmas time, and due to his heavy program at Rajbhavan, he also could not physically present here. He will give a message through online and will inaugurate this meeting. So we express our gratitude for giving your best wishes through your message in spite of your busy schedule. So we welcome you to this meeting. His Grace Giorgis Markurilos, who presides this Jubilee meeting, is the Metropolitan of Mumbai Diocese of Orthodox Church. Late lamented His Grace Thomas Marathanasios and His Grace Kurilos Tirumeni were close associates. As an elder brother, he respected Bishop Thomas Tirumeni with a short notice, agreed to preside this meeting. Baroda was under his jurisdiction before it was divided into Mumbai and Ahmedabad. Tirumeni himself, a good organizer, administrator and educationist. There are a number of schools and colleges in Mumbai and other areas of Mumbai Diocese under his management. Neil Tirumeni, with all humility, we welcome you to this Jubilee meeting. I welcome you to this meeting on behalf of all the people present here. Sri Jayendra Singh Ji Parmar, popularly called Jayu Dada, is the MLA of Halol. He is elected 5 times continuously from this constituency. He hails from the royal family of Kanjeri, a princely state in the district of Panchamagals. His leadership qualities combined with royal qualities of compassion and selfless service made him a true mass leader. He was very close to Bishop Athanasius, and even now he is very close to the Halol principal, Reverend Father Manu Varghese. He was in the state cabinet twice. Sir, we welcome you wholeheartedly. Sri C.K. Koshyari, former additional chief secretary of Gujarat, has got a great admiration and respect for late lament His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasius. The remaining used to call him Kunyamon, his pet name. Sir Koshi, sir, proved the integrity and efficiency throughout his career. Sir Koshi, sir, we welcome you to this Jubilee meeting with all humility. I welcome all distinguished guests, Reverend Fathers, principals, staff, students, and parents of all schools, and all well-wishers present here in this meeting. Jai Bharat.
Thank you, Father. Mr. P.S. Sridharan Pillai is the 19th Honorable Governor of Goa and has authored more than 200 books, which traverse an astonishing range of subjects from history, politics, and law to poetry and economy. Mr. Pillai firmly abides by his maxim that art and literature can unite people. Even though he is physically not present amongst us due to some urgent official program, he will deliver the inaugural address online. For that, I request the dignitaries on the dais to make themselves comfortable to see the online address.
His Holiness More and More Basil Marthoma Matthews III, Tirmini, Reverend Dr. M.S. Yohanan Ramban, Honorable MLA Yedarshan Singhi, Sri C.K. Koshi, IAS, Sri Varghese Thomas, Sri Shaji Matai, honorable guests, well-wishers, believers, teaching and non-teaching staff, my dear friends. I am very sorry to inform you that I am not in a position to come to Baroda and attend today's program. I agreed to come, especially the Catholic Baba Tirmini is attending a program in which I am getting an opportunity to inaugurate the Golden Jubilee meeting of this great institution, St. Paul's School, Kovil, Baroda. And of course, this meeting is conducting in the Nagar in the name of Mar Athanasius Tirmeni. Mar Athanasius Tirmeni, I mean late Bishop Thomas Mar Athanasius, was a great missionary, educationist, philanthropist, and above all, a good human being. And in my native place, Chengannur, he was the bishop, and always he bestowed blessings to me, and my cordial relationship with him still keeping in my mind. I am paying my homage to Bishop Thomas Mar Athanasius Tirmeni, and I am extremely happy to see that a good institution, education institution, namely the St. Basil Society School in Vadodara, is producing good citizens through education. And I'm told that 5 other institutions also voted by Mar Athanasius Tirmeni is running in Gujarat in an excellent manner. I would like to say that the contribution of Christian community in general, and especially by Orthodox Sabha headed by Parishuddha Kadulika Baba Tirmeni, is doing wonderful job in charity activities as well as educational activities in Kerala. I am coming from a village in namely Venmani, in which Orthodox Sabha's church is so familiar among the people, irrespective of caste, creed, or any other different entities. Our cordial relationship, especially between Orthodox believers and Hindu believers in my village, is a classic example for our ancient concept of Sarva Dharma Samabhavana. During my school days, my parents always directed me to go to the church and pray in front of it before I was going for examinations. This type of exchange of even faiths between Hindu and Christian communities through Orthodox Sabha's old church is a commendable thing. Even our constitution also guarantees that cordial relationship between all religions of our country. And the slogan of this trust which is running this school is Upasana Svadhyaya Seva. Upasana of course means dedication to something for the society. Svadhyaya of course represents the education, and Seva means service to the human beings. The service to the human beings is a service to God according to Bharatiya concept. I am very happy to say that Parishuddha Kadulika Baba Tirmeni, after assuming the present position, is always giving importance through his church, through his Sabha, and through his activities for the betterment of the needy people, whether they belongs to Hindu, Christian or Muslim, whatever it may be, helping hand is there from Orthodox Sabha through its head, and I am as governor of Goa and as a citizen from Kerala, I am extending my sincere thanks to this great Sabha. And this Sabha's importance is that it always declares that truly an Indian Sabha. A Sabha, Christian Sabha, a denomination, always declaring that truly an Indian Sabha and proudly presenting that before the society and its believers is an important thing. Even our Honorable Prime Minister of India, while he was the Chief Minister of Gujarat, he had occasion to see Thomas Marathonius Tirumeni, and I had occasion to hear from the mouth of our Prime Minister that he was respecting Thomas Marathonius Tirumeni and educational activities he was doing in Gujarat was appreciated by the then Chief Minister of Gujarat. According to my information, late Bishop Thomas Marathonius firmly believed that, quote, the destiny of India is being shaped in her classrooms. So a visionary, a person who's dedicated his entire life for the cause of Jesus and the Christian way of life, he declared that his life ambition and his main focus on his activities was intending the destiny of India is being shaped in her classrooms. This appreciation of the country's growth and education, I mean classrooms, are selected as the basis for the development of the country. And now we, our Indians, our Bharatiyas as such together are trying to achieve the goal of a Vishwaguru. And for that purpose, the Orthodox Sabha's great former bishop, late Bishop Thomas Marathonius, was a very good and appreciating aspect, and I am requesting all of you should follow the firm steps shown by the Tirumeni. I would like to visit this school whenever I am getting a chance in future, and I am, with the permission of all of you and with the blessings of our Catholic Baba Tirumeni, I declare that this Golden Jubilee celebration is declared as inaugurated. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, sir. His Holiness Basilius Marthoma Matthews III was enthroned as Catholicos of the East and Malankara Metropolitan, the Supreme Head of Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church of India on 15th October 2021. Even though he is physically not present amongst us, but he will deliver the presidential address through online.
Pray be to the Triune God, distinguished guests on the dais, invited guests, staff from the institutions of the Trust of St. Basil, members of the Trust, friends and well-wishers. Today, as we gather to celebrate the Golden Jubilee of the Trust of St. Basil in Baroda, we stand on the shoulders of giants, visionaries, and pioneers who have a century ago planted the seeds of education in the fertile soil of Gujarat. It is an honor and privilege to address you on this historic occasion, reflecting not only on the past but also on the enduring legacy that we carry forward. 50 years ago, in the year 1966, a vision took root. A young and dynamic soul named Katie Thomas, hailing from Kerala, arrived in MS University, Baroda, on a UGC scholarship with a dream of making a difference through education. Little did he know that his journey would not only lead to personal academic achievements, but also lay the foundation for a transformative movement. Inspired by a deep sense of purpose, Katie Thomas organized a congregation of Orthodox Christians in Baroda, and that led to the foundation of Baroda Mar Gregorio's Orthodox Parish. Through the relentless efforts of Father Katie Thomas, who was later ordained as a priest of the Malagara Orthodox Church, the Trust of St. Basil was established in 1973. The driving force behind this initiative was the commitment to provide affordable and quality education to the children in the rural areas of Gujarat. Father Katie Thomas later elevated to the position as a bishop and was known as Metropolitan Thomas Marathanasius. Marathanasius shared the belief of Mahatma Gandhi that the development of India hinges on the progress of its villages, and the quality of education is indispensable for this development. Today, the Trust of St. Basil manages 5 schools in various villages of Gujarat, embodying the vision and principles set forth by Bishop Athanasius. The St. Basil Trust, through these schools, has been a beacon of hope and knowledge, offering education without discrimination of caste, creed, or gender. The motto of these schools, "Knowledge is Brahma, adore it," reflects the profound understanding of the transformative power of education. We pay homage to the great visionary, educationist, and philanthropist Bishop Athanasius, who departed from our midst on 24th August 2018. His legacy lives on through the thousands of patriotic and responsible citizens the schools have nurtured. Now, serve our country and the world in various capacities. As we celebrate the Golden Jubilee, let us renew our commitment to the noble cause that Bishop Athanasius and all those who have been part of this incredible journey champion. Let us continue to be torchbearers of education, empowering generations to come. We extend our heartfelt congratulations to the Trust of St. Basil on reaching this momentous milestone. May the next 50 years be marked by even greater achievements, broader impact, and a continued dedication to the noble cause of providing quality education to the children in the rural areas of Gujarat. Together, let us ensure that the flame of knowledge continues to burn brightly, lighting the way for a brighter and more enlightened future. Thank you, and may God bless the Trust of St. Basil abundantly.
Thank you. you, His Holiness. For felicitation, I request the dignitaries. Mar Gurilos, Metropolitan of Mumbai Diocese of the Indian Orthodox Church, was born on 17th October 1949. He took his Bachelor's in Arts from the Calicut University and MA from Sri Venkateshwara University. He did his BD from Orthodox Theological Seminary, Kottayam, and Postgraduate Diploma in Pastoral Theology from Heythrope College, London University, and Postgraduate Diploma in Theology and Mission from Urban Theology Unit, Sheffield, UK. His Grace has held many positions in the Church and other Christian organizations. At present, he is the Bishop of Mumbai Diocese. Now I invite, with due respect, His Grace for his felicitation speech.
Praise be the name of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Sri Jedrath Singh Ji Parmar, Sri C.K. Koshi IAS, Reverend Johannan Ramban, Without Fathers, the trustees of this society, Sri Varghese Thomas, Sri Shaji Matai, all the beloved ones, including the principals, former principals, staff and students, all the beloved ones who are very closely associated with this institution. After receiving the wonderful words of wisdom, knowledge, as well as blessing from His Holiness Moranma Basilios Marthoma Matthews III, Catholicos and Malagar Metropolitan, who is on the apostolic throne of St. Thomas, the beloved disciple of Jesus Christ, whose martyrdom was celebrated a few days back. And His Excellency Sri Sridharanji, who is heading and leading Goa as the first man of that category, as the Honorable Governor of Goa. We are privileged to join together, and may I take this opportunity to join all of you to praise God Almighty for the remarkable set of blessings we could have in and through this trust Society of St. Basil, headed by a very dynamic, a remarkable leader who was down to earth but with a crystal clear clarity in his mind to bring the downtrodden and the marginalized to the mainstream in and through proper education, upbringing, and helping them out to be the wonderful citizens of this great Bharat Mata, who could and shall contribute in plenty in and through their different levels of talents. I met late lamented Dr. Thomas Marathanesis first time while I was along with hundreds of young people was taking the morning bath in a river in a place called Parvam in back in Kerala in connection with the annual conference of the youth organization. I was escorted by my elder brother, and during the morning bath he said in Malayalam, this is Babu, either Babu sir. പൊത്തങ്കാവിൽ കൊച്ചു തിരുമേനിയുടെ നെവിയാണ്. മൈ എൽഡർ ബ്രദർ ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ്ഡ് ദ ഗ്രേറ്റ് വണ്ടർഫുൾ ഫിഗർ ആസ് ബാബു സാർ, ദാറ്റ് വാസ് ഹിസ് പെറ്റ് നെയിം. ഹി വാസ് എ ലേ പേഴ്സൺ ആൻഡ് ഇൻ ടേൺ ഹി ആസ്ക്ഡ് മൈ ബ്രദർ ജോസഫ് ദാര. സോ ഐ വാസ് ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ്ഡ് ടു ഹിം ആസ് ഹിസ് യങ്ങർ ബ്രദർ. Thirumeni inquired about me, and that was the starting of a new journey together. He was already a teacher. Later, he became the principal of the school, and he started off many schools in this area, as you know. Not only the five schools, but the first, very first school, Basil School, was given shape by him. It was more than 50 years back. Nowadays, the whole of India, and in particular, the state of Gujarat, is very clearly focusing to bring the villagers to the mainstream in and through proper education, healthcare, and so many related plans and projects. But more than 50 years back, I think the elderly people are quite aware. Even the city of Baroda was not well equipped to face the challenges of the modern setup of proper education and helping out and in particular the weaker section of the society. But Mr. K.T. Thomas, later who became a priest, Father Thomas, was determined, had a crystal clear mind and total surrender to see that not only quality education will be brought into even the most deprived set of people will be enabled to come up. He did plan to have so many scholarships, different levels of one-to-one tuition and facilities. He was literally after the principal and the staff. And so many elderly people who are seated here, who had been in the field of education, will witness and underline my words, assuring the methodology he has developed, the concern, the care, so that the cure in terms of equipping the most disinterested kids to be brought to the main line. You may be surprised because I myself had been wondering In many an occasions, some of the students at the minimum from all his schools could be brought back to Kerala, such a far off place, during his early days of his steps in terms of this transformation. And some of the not only the students, but elderly people, including the teachers and people who are committed in the field of education, were brought to this part of the world, giving impetus, encouragement, and bringing challenges in the minds of them, so that the interaction, the effective communication, and proper conviction of this great goal could be underlined, and many people could hold on to it. As a metropolitan, he has had the privilege of all these blessings. If he were here, seeing this beloved MLA, I'm more than sure would have come and hugged him and welcomed him. That would have been much more beautiful than the bouquet we could offer. The connection with Mr. C.K. Koshi, my AS, whenever he used to have a chance of meeting him, he will utter his words, "Hi, Kunjumai," which is his pet name. But with the starting point, the hugging, holding, and owning will be a remarkable skill in which he will be completely enslaved. The affection and the attachment, not only for these great personalities, but other people in different levels of the principals or the teachers, even the small kids. If he could identify even a single talent, that will be appreciated, that will be promoted, that will be encouraged. That was the charisma of late lamented Dr. Marazanesius. I was privileged to watch him very closely. What are his talents? What is his commitment? He was not only giving frame to five or other five schools in and around Baroda or Gujarat, but he was given the responsibility of all the schools of the Malagra Orthodox Church during a particular time. During that responsibility also, he has been clearly focusing how these institutions can be brought up. You may be surprised, I am excited to say, even two centuries back, when India was in a paganic background, the then metropolitan, the predecessor of His Holiness, you met online, was so charismatic to start dozens of schools back in Kerala. Our theological seminary was the base for the first occasion in southern part of India to raise the voice of English language to be printed in any part of South India. So this church has been holding on the priority in terms of the transformation, which is the only possibility for a community like that of India to be brought to the main line. Last year I had been spending 100 days visiting USA and Canada. Before that, before the COVID, the Bombay Diocese was planning to start the university. We had dozens of meetings. We plan to start a space so that we will be having international connection with the most prestigious institutions all through the globe. To have specialists coming over here and addressing the students, at least during a semester, the young people will be getting a chance to go to Israel for horticulture, Japan and Korea for agriculture, or most passionate spaces in terms of the science and technology advancements in worldwide very reputed institutions. We have been dreaming. But unfortunately, after the COVID, the situation is completely changed. Any young person who can have help enough to walk around are flying away from India. It's true that the whole country is dynamically focusing to see that even the downtrodden and the marginalized will be given quality education. But as a shock, we see that the youngsters who are remaining in India are very limited. Majority are flying and migrating to different parts of the country, of the world. It's a costly affair as far as the intelligentsia of this wonderful country is concerned. So this is a turning point. After the demise of Mother Teresa, and while you and me are in the field of having new thoughts and a beautiful frame to the education setup, what should be our priority? What methodology can be brought? More than what I said in terms of shocking, many of the youngsters are turned into drugs and drinks. The focus is getting lost. In this changing scenario, the presence of the leadership and the dynamism and the commitment, the vision and mission of late lamented Mother Teresa is of supreme importance. It's a great blessing that we are participating in a wonderful occasion in which we are celebrating the Golden Jubilee celebration of a society which is stressed, which has been surviving in this part of the country, substantially contributing. Fruitful and effective steps have been taken, and that legacy is being continued. Let's praise God Almighty for the blessings. But at the same time, I think we have to reshape, remold, and the commitment should be sharpened and deepened. And I love to look at the trustees of this prestigious society to see that the challenges of modern world, and in particular in this part of the country, will be owned and taken care of. And this august body has got a very important role to play. When we salute this wonderful personality, it's our commitment. If somebody is disappearing, another 100 should commit and bow our heads before God and also for a greater cause, without which this type of legacies won't be continued. Provided we commit ourselves, we can have a golden tomorrow. A person with a golden tongue, not only in terms of his oration, not only in terms of his salutation, not only in terms of his relationship, not only in terms of identifying the weaker or the breakup setting, but he will be molding, giving shape, strengthening, encouraging, challenging, and promoting. And for that, he'll be clearly setting his mind and soul. body and spirit, to give shape to those thoughts, and the vision and mission will be implemented effectively so that other people will be owning. That's the reason why these institutions could be a great success. It's not fair on my part. Great personalities are yet to speak. But I am very specially privileged. Till 5 days back, I never expected that I will be getting a chance to come out here. I was withheld for various reasons. I am so glad and grateful to God, thankful to the members of the society, the trust, and as a respect to the great personalities of our suburbia. And I humbly place my appeal that this august body, we take up the responsibility and identify the call and the role and identify this great personality as our model. Thirdly, by grace and blessing of God Almighty, we'll also be enabled to march together so that this Bharat Mala will be blessed in and through our commitment, our vision and mission, and which will be useful in the hands of God as useful instruments for a glorious future in terms of the transformation in and through the education field, if not other areas as well. Paying homage, getting into the space of intercession of this great personality. And as a great brother, I salute him and long to have his pamphlet all through my life. And along with him, I praise God Almighty for the achievements of this institution. We have passed through 50 years of successful achievements. The other moments is a build up further up so that the community will be benefited, most needy people will be elevated, and the phase of Bharat Mala will be completely transformed. And on a later date, with heart, I am quite sure that many of the wonderful people who are leaving this country will be attracted to serve in this country, so that this country will be strengthened further, and all the value system will be retained and enhanced, so that Bharat Mala will be in a greater priority, space of pride, and the colorful setting of the celebration will continue and will be a part of it. May God bless each and everyone. I congratulate this trust on this occasion of the Golden Jubilee. I pray that ever so many blessings will be in its future endeavors, so that many people will be blessed and Bharat Mala will be pleased to identify our heart services and the contributions to the people in total. God bless.
Thank you, His Grace. Shri Jaitra Singh Ji Parmar is the Member of Legislative Assembly, Gujarat, representing Halol constituency, and is a former Minister of Gujarat. He is a good friend of our late Bishop, and his contribution has been immense in the development of MGM School, Halol. His leadership has played a pivotal role and has always helped the trust in implementing its vision. Now I invite Shri Jaitra Singh Ji Parmar for the speech.
Holiness Basilius Marthoma Matthews, Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillaiji, Honorable Governor of Goa, His Grace Givarjis Mark Curilis, Mr. C.K. Kosi sir, IAS, Dr. M.S. Yohanan Ramben, Mr. Vargis Thomas, Mr. Saji Mathai, Board of Trustees, the Trust of the Society of St. Basil, Father Manu Vargis Jacob, Fathers, Principals, Staff, and the esteemed guests gathered here to celebrate the Golden Jubilee of the Trust of the Society of St. Basil. I congratulate the Trust for inspiring excellence for 50 years and beyond, a journey marked by dedication, resilience, and the pursuit of excellence. The founders have planted the seeds of knowledge and nurtured a thriving academy community. This Golden Jubilee is not just a celebration of time that passed. It's a tribute to the countless individuals who have contributed to its success. The visionary leader, committed educators, and the generations of students who have pursued their education in these institutions, leaving an invisible mark. I congratulate the visionary leader of the Trust, its founder president, late Laminate, His Grace Thomas Mar Anthonius, in his heavenly abode for this golden journey of success. I have been in close association with Bishop as one of his educational institutions is in our town, Halol. The first English medium school in Halol was started by Bishop. His idea of focusing on the development of backward areas by starting schools there in itself shows the industrious nature of the great leader. That one school has inspired many others to follow pursuit. This has given the opportunity of the quality education to the children, thereby positively affecting the lives of many people. It has enhanced in people the significance of education and pursuing education when it is available at your doorstep, all due to the foresightness of a visionary. My interaction with Bishop has been illuminating and enlightening. I have always found him to be a distinguished educator and an esteemed administrator with a contagious, radiant personality. Bishop had a warm and captivating personality and ever-smiling face. Bishop's concerns have always been regarding the development of the society. He has continuously endeavored for the welfare and upliftment of the society. Bishop's role in igniting the spark of leadership, competitiveness, cooperation, empathy, hard work in the minds and hearts of the students through various curricular, co-curricular and extracurricular activities has been eminent in making them responsible citizens of Bharat. I have witnessed the success of Bishop's students in various such activities at school and higher levels. Whenever I have visited the school, its natural and serene atmosphere has been refreshing. The school and its premises are totally environment friendly, with an open playground surrounded by trees for the children to play. Well-ventilated classrooms, all these perceived by the visionary well in advance. The sapling of the trees that stand tall today have been planted even before the building was constructed. Bishop will always be remembered as a great spiritual leader and a selfless philanthropist whose life was a message in itself. His pioneering efforts in institution building will be remembered with gratitude by everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Sri C.K. Koshi, IAS, retired in 2005 as Additional Chief Secretary, Government of Gujarat after a long and illustrious career spanning 37 years. He is a gold medalist in MA Political Science and Public Administration from the University of Kerala. He was the founder and managing director of the Tourism Corporation of Gujarat and principal secretary of such crucial departments as Industries, Revenue, Sardar Sarovar Nigam and Information. He has served as secretary to the Chief Minister of Gujarat and as chairman of Gujarat State Petroleum Corporation. In the Government of India, he was financial advisor to the Department of Atomic Energy and executive director to the Nuclear Power Corporation of India. He has taught courses in governance and public policy to postgraduate students at CEPT University. He was the first executive director of the Center for Heritage Management at Ahmedabad University and later advisor to the CEPT Research and Development Foundation. I request Sri C.K. Koshi to deliver his speech.
Your Grace, Giver Gismar Kurilos, Metropolitan of the Bombay Diocese, the Honorable Sri Jayadrath Singhji, MLA, former Minister of the Government of Gujarat, the Right Reverend Dr. M.S. Yohannon Ramban, President of the Society of St. Basil, Sri Shaji Matthew, Secretary of the Trust, Sri Varghese Treasurer, Reverend Fathers, students and friends. It is indeed a very rare occasion for me to be sharing the dais with such luminaries. And the theme which has brought us all together on this platform is, of course, the Golden Jubilee of the Trust of Society of St. Basil. As each and every speaker before me has pointed out, in celebrating the Jubilee, we are also celebrating the remarkable life and the noble achievements of a unique personality, His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasius. With utmost humility, I can claim that my association with Athanasius Thirumeni stretches back exactly half a century before he was even elevated to a bishop. And thus, I can rightfully claim, Thirumeni, that I have borne witness to the birth and the growth of the Society of St. Basil. Even though I had met him several times, my real friendship with Athanasius Thirumeni started in about mid-75 when I was posted in Bharuch and the then K.T. Thomas father came visiting, and it was clear to me even from my first meeting that here was an individual with fire in his belly and stars in his eyes. We spent several long evenings and he would share with me his dreams of building some institution which would make a lasting contribution to society. And though much has been said about the society, we all agree, and every speaker has mentioned, that it is the man behind the institution, the person who created the infrastructure, whom we celebrate today and honor today. And when I look back at the 50 odd years I have known him, there are three characteristics that mark him as an extraordinary human being. The first has been mentioned by everybody here, his passion and commitment to education as a tool, not merely for the development of society, but to free the minds of the next generation from ignorance that had so long fettered our country. He strongly believed that if India is to take its rightful place among the nations of the world, then our next generation must be intellectually equipped to take on global competition. He firmly believed that our human resources were equal to the best in the world. What was needed was quality education imparted at an affordable cost and delivered by trained and committed teachers. Like our former President Abdul Kalam, Thirumeni also believed in igniting young minds and setting them free to soar as high as their dreams would take them. And thus was born the Society of Saint Basil. Secondly, even though Thirumeni's faith was deeply rooted in the Malankara Orthodox Sabha, his outlook was truly secular. His schools were open to children of all castes and communities and religions. It would have been very easy for him to start institutions with a strong bias and tilt to the Christian Sabha. Instead, he actively propagated the philosophy that every citizen of India deserved a seat at the high table of education. He used to regale me with stories of how he used to pick up, literally pick up, poor and promising students and invite them to his school irrespective of their faith or caste or community. He kept a refreshingly open mind, and he has invited me to witness cultural programs from diverse cultural backgrounds and languages. We now know, looking back, that in practicing the tenet that all human beings are equal, he was in fact practicing the highest tenets of Christianity itself. It was fortunate that he lived long enough to see some of the fruits of this philosophy. And as was mentioned here earlier, many of the pass-outs and graduates of these five institutions are today eminent doctors, engineers, technicians all over India and the world, and working as productive and useful citizens of India. Thirdly, Athanasios Thirumeni literally adopted Gujarat as his second home. He hailed from Kerala, and many of us know how geographically, culturally, and linguistically Gujarat is different from Kerala. But that did not deter him from making Gujarat his karma bhumi. I think he literally fell in love with the state. He traveled the length and breadth of Gujarat, meeting and interacting with not just Malayalis, but with people from every walk of life. In the process, he endeared himself to the locals, and they welcomed him into their homes as their very friendly and beloved Father Thomas. Even after he became a bishop, he would always try to use the Gujarat model in Chengannur. Not very successfully, I'm afraid, but he loved the sense of philanthropy, the hard work, the community participation of Gujarat, and tried his best to see if that could be emulated in Kerala. So on this Golden Jubilee celebrations, my sincere congratulations to Reverend Yohanan Ramban and his team for keeping alive the flame and carrying the torch forward. I wish them all the best and hope and pray that the good work initiated by Athanasios Thirumeni will be taken to new heights. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Prasad ma'am and Mishra ma'am were the first two teachers appointed by our late Bishop Thomas Mar Athanasios when he took up the management of Gujarat Refinery English Medium School in 1973. I request Mathai sir to say a few words about them.
Thank you.
1973, when Father K.T. Thomas took over the management of Gujarat Refinery English Medium School, already there was an English Medium School there. It was started in 1964. And some of the teachers were already working there. So when Father Thomas took over the management of the school, Indian Oil Corporation called all the teachers and told them, you have two options. Either you could join our Gujarati medium school as a regular teacher with all the benefits of Indian Oil Corporation, or you can join with Father Thomas. Three young ladies, three young teachers, Mrs. Prasad, Mrs. S. Mishra, and Mrs. N. C. Kopkar. They were called Trimurtis. They opted to join with Father Thomas. Out of that, Mrs. N. C. Kopkar passed away a few years back. And Mrs. Mishra, she wanted to attend this program, but she is in New Delhi. But Mrs. Prasad is here. Later on, she was elevated as the headmistress of our secondary and the higher secondary section. When I joined the school in 1987 as a teacher, she was the headmistress of our second and higher secondary section. She is about 84 years old, difficulties in walking. Still, she is here on behalf of the trust. I express our gratitude to Mrs. Prasad as well as welcome her to this meeting and to this function.
Let's felicitate her with a shawl, and for that I request His Grace to do the honors. May I request Nisha ma'am and Sandhya ma'am to escort Prasad ma'am to the dais.
I request all of you stand up and honor her.
Is not able to attend the program due to some unavoidable circumstances, but she has sent a message and I would read it out, which says, first of all, I congratulate the Society of Saint Basil on the occasion of its golden jubilee. At this time, I very much miss His Grace Bishop Thomas, who was a great visionary and an educationist. Under his guidance, the school has fulfilled its mission of imparting education and moral values in the students. He considered the Gujarat Refinery English Medium School as his family. She says, my congratulations to Mr. Mathai also, who took up the responsibility of the schools and took them to great heights. Here's a message from Mrs. Bakshi, Mrs. Meera Bakshi, former headmistress of Gujarat Refinery English Medium School. She conveys her congratulations to all the members of the Trust of the Society of St. Basil. She says, it is indeed a historic moment. During these 50 years, education has been received by uncountable students in the trust schools over all over Gujarat. We remember with great regard our founder and mentor, His Grace Bishop Thomas, whose maximum guidance, contribution and commitment has been instrumental in establishing renowned schools. Now I invite Shri Shaji Mathai, Secretary of the Trust of the Society of Saint Basil, to express the words of gratitude.
His Grace Givargis Mar Kurilos, Sri Jayendra Singh Ji Parmar, Sri C. K. Koshi, Reverend Dr. M. S. Yuhanan Ramban, Sri Varghese Thomas, Srimadi N. N. Prasad, Reverend Fathers, invited guests, former and present staff of the Trust, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, let me pay respect and homage to late lamented His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasios, our Guru, guide and mentor, the founder president of the Society of St. Basil. As it was already mentioned by all the speakers, he was a great visionary, educationist, religious leader, philanthropist, and above all, a good human being. Due to his toil, tears and sweat, he built up various educational institutions in Gujarat to create intellectually sharp, emotionally balanced and morally sound citizens. Even though physically he is not present here, his invisible guidance and ideals inspire us, the trustees and the dedicated staff of our institutions, to realize his vision and dream. My formal duty is to express our sincere gratitude and thanks to all persons who have contributed in one way or the other in making this function a success. His Holiness Moron Mar Basilios Marthoma Matthews III, the head of the Indian Orthodox Church and a trustee of our trust, has agreed to come here and preside over this meeting and bless this occasion. But it was informed that he is not keeping well and doctors have advised him not to travel. But he was kind enough to deliver his speech online. On behalf of the Trust, with due respect, I extend our gratitude to His Holiness. When we invited Sri P. S. Sridharan Pillai, Honorable Governor of Goa, to inaugurate this meeting, he assured us that he would come provided no other important and urgent engagements are there. But last week, we were informed that due to some very important program, it was not possible for him to attend the meeting. But he was gracious enough to inaugurate the meeting online. I, on behalf of the Trust, extend our sincere thanks to Honorable Governor Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai. His Grace Givargis Mar Kurilos, Metropolitan of the Bombay Diocese of Indian Orthodox Church, has a long association with our late Bishop Mar Athanasios. His Grace is kind enough to attend this Jubilee meeting. On behalf of the Trust, I express our gratitude to you, Your Grace. Sri Jayendra Singh Ji Parmar, Honorable MLA of Halol and ex-Minister of Gujarat, was a friend of late Bishop and a well-wisher of the Trust. In spite of his incredible schedule, he accepted our invitation and attended the meeting. I am happy to express our sincere thanks to you, sir. Sri C.K. Koshi, IAS, is a well-wisher of our Trust and a friend of late His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasios. When I invited him for this meeting, he already accepted it. Sir, we are thankful to you for attending this Jubilee meeting. Reverend Dr. M. S. Yuhanan Ramban and Sri Varghese Thomas are the President and Treasurer of our Trust. I thank both of them for their guidance and support in organizing this meeting. I also profusely thank Reverend Fathers, invited guests, well-wishers, former staff of the Trust and present staff, student volunteers for their gracious presence here. I thank various departments of the government, people who have provided various infrastructure and security personnel for their help and support. The principals and staff of St. Paul's School, both English medium and Gujarati medium, deserves special thanks for coordinating and arranging all the required things for this function. Special thanks to all St. Paul's family members. Our late bishop used to say, if you help someone's children, God will help your children. All our staff, please keep this sentence in your mind. Thank you, Jai Hind.
As we all know, the Trust of the Society of St. Basil is celebrating its Golden Jubilee this year. The Trust was established in 1973 by the vision and effort of our founder president to provide good education to children in Gujarat in rural areas. That we could see through a documentary titled as A Journey of 50 Years by a Visionary in the Field of Education. For that, I request the dignitaries on the dais to make themselves comfortable and to let the volunteers adjust their chairs so that they can witness the documentary presentation.
Journey of a Visionary in Search of Excellence in the Field of Education. A jubilee is an occasion to be celebrated to recall the marvelous ways in which the school or trust has fulfilled its mission in imparting education, moral, spiritual values, and discipline to help build up responsible citizens whom our society needs today. The Trust of the Society of St. Basil was established in 1973 by the initiative and leadership of its founder president, late lamented His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasius, who was a priest of Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church, at that time as Father K.T. Thomas. It is a charitable trust registered under the Bombay Public Trust Act 1950. Late His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasius has dedicated his life to give to the society enlightenment through quality education. The path he had chosen and the goal set by him had the maxim Upasana Swadhyay Seva, which means worship, self-study, service. The vision of the trust is to create intellectually sharp, emotionally balanced, and morally sound citizens. The mission of the trust is to impart sound education at a reasonable cost to the boys and girls of all communities without any discrimination, and to prepare them to live and act as responsible and patriotic citizens of India. Mr. K.T. Thomas inherited rich priestly heritage and is 42nd in the priestly generation and the 5th bishop in the ancient Vadake Thalikkal family in Kerala. He was born to Mr. K.T. Thomas and Mrs. Eliyamma Thomas on the 3rd of April 1938. He was very much inspired by his mother, whose prayers helped him to be a priest and then a bishop. A young and enthusiastic visionary came to Baroda in 1966 with a UGC scholarship to pursue his master's in education in MS University. After completing his M.Ed, he started thinking about establishing school in Gujarat to provide good and quality education to the students in rural areas. A sentence given in Kothari Commission report, the destiny of India has been shaped in her classrooms, greatly influenced him. After which, he took over the reins of Babyland School in Alkapuri and gained enough experience to run a school. In 1969, due to his initiative, Basil School was started in Baroda by the Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church and became the founder principal of Basil School and made a name of its own during initial years itself. In 1970, Mr. K.T. Thomas was ordained as a priest and became Father K.T. Thomas. In 1973, the Indian Oil Corporation Limited approached Father K.T. Thomas to take over their Gujarat Refinery English Medium School in Refinery Township, Vadodara. As per the request of the Indian Oil Corporation, the trust took over the management of the Refinery English Medium School. He toiled hard and due to his tireless pursuance with the support of his team of dedicated teachers, he converted the Gujarat Refinery English Medium School into one of the best reputed schools in Baroda within a short span of time. He presented his first batch for the Gujarat Board Examination in 1976 and secured 100% result. In 1981, at the request of parents in Halol, the Society of St. Basil started MGM, Mar Gregorius Memorial School, Halol in Panchmahal District. In 1983, the Petrofilms management requested him to start an English medium primary school in their township in Petrofilms Nagar, Baroda. As per their request, St. Paul's English medium school was started. After 2 years, Petrofilms management handed over the Gujarati medium school also to the Society of St. Basil and it was named St. Paul's School Gujarati Medium School. At St. Paul's Baroda, when it was at the verge of closure after the liquidation of Petrofilms company, His Grace thought about future of 1500 students and was compelled to construct a huge school building at Koyali and was inaugurated by then Honorable Governor Shri O.P. Koyali in 2016. Subsequently, at the request of the Petrofilms management, an English medium school named St. Paul's School was started in 1991 at Ankleshwar in their township. Later, it was shifted to Kosambadi in Ankleshwar. In 2009, a CBSE school, Basilios Public School, was started in Refinery Township, Baroda, as per the request of the Indian Oil Corporation Limited. Being an educationist, his approach was completely child-oriented, and nothing is more important to him than the welfare of all-round development of the students. He had novel ideas for improving teaching techniques, and he inspired even the mediocre students to excel. Consequently, today there are 100 of his children who are serving the society as successful doctors, engineers, teachers, researchers, executives, and above all, responsible citizens and human beings. He was a disciplinarian and demanded discipline from others as well. His continuous guidance to his teachers on education programs and planning, introducing innovative teaching methods and a loving approach to children had helped them to blossom into good human beings and responsible citizens. All his reputed schools stand as the epitome of his toil, tears and sweat. The motto of his life was search for excellence. Meanwhile, in 1985, Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church elevated Father K.T. Thomas as a bishop of the church. His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasius was appointed as the first metropolitan of the Chengalur Diocese in Kerala. By extending his helping hand to many needy students, he has transformed many lives, and today all his students are well placed in different walks of life. A person with a golden heart. His dream of providing quality education to the rural students led him to a mission of setting 5 schools in the rural areas of Gujarat, which made him a true friend of Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi. His love and affection towards nature and mankind is sincere and undiluted. He is a true nature lover, a farmer. He believed that before cutting a tree, one should try to plant 5 more trees for the next generation to come. He always used to tell his teachers, "If you help somebody's children, God will take care of your children." Very good, fine, proceed, were his motivational magical words of appreciation with an Athanasius touch, which helped all who knew him move further and achieve their best in their lives. The philosophy of his grace was, search for excellence in all spheres of life. In 1983, the Trust started inter-school debate competition in English, and then it had started inter-school quiz competition for the primary section 22 years ago, and later debate in Gujarati was started in the year 2017. The Trust not only believes in developing its students intellectually but also physically and morally in good spirits of sportsmanship, for which it started with the inter-school football and badminton tournament for boys and girls respectively. He left for heavenly abode on the 24th of August 2018. Death of founder president His Grace Thomas Mar Athanasius is indeed an irreparable loss to the nation. Life has an end, as a candlelight would fade, but in hearts, memories yielded would forever be embedded. All his educational institutions are the monuments of his great contribution in the field of education. The memory of His Grace is being preserved in the Mar Athanasius Museum at Halol, and his tomb is built in Kerala. Lessons with his examples. May his soul rest in peace. We will follow his ideals and make country proud. Now it's time to hear his thoughts in his own voice.
1966, when I landed in Baroda with a UGC scholarship to do my postgraduate studies in MS University of Baroda, that was the time when the Kothari Commission report was published. I purchased a copy from Acharya Book Depot and started reading it. One sentence which I found in the first page of the report is still in my mind. The sentence is this: the destiny of our nation is shaped in the classrooms. I always keep this in my mind and work very hard. The reason why the present Prime Minister respects me a lot is because all my schools are in the rural areas of Gujarat. In Koyali village, we have now three. Last year it was four schools. This year there are three schools. And one in Panjimahal district, the most backward district in Gujarat, Halol, we have a school. And in Angleser, Kosambadi village, we have another school. All our schools are in the rural areas of Gujarat. And our children are all well praised in life. And I am very happy to say, last year, on the 5th of September, when the whole country was celebrating Teachers Day, early in the morning, I had a call from one of my ex-students from the Rishravandi school, Neelam Maheshwari from Australia. She is an associate professor of medicine in a medical college in Australia. The second call came from Canada, Toronto, from one of my ex-students from Rishravandi school, Mr. Santosh Vasudevan. He is a very high official in the IT field. The third call came from Florida. Why I mentioned these three cases is to prove that all my children are well placed in different parts of the world. That is my intention also. I want my children to come up and occupy good positions in society.
Athanasius means immortal, and he lives in our hearts eternally. A remarkable journey, and we all felt nostalgic going through the documentary. Now I request everybody to rise for national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, high tea is arranged for everybody at this basketball court. You please attend high tea also, everybody. All of you have present here, invited guests, former staff, present staff, volunteers, everybody. Volunteers and the St. Paul School teachers, please guide them.
Hello. Hello.